A very good afternoon, all the dignitaries present over here and all my fellow participants. Myself, Pooja Pardeshi, MSc First Year, Government Institute of Forensic Science, Nagpur, Maharashtra. Today's my topic is digital forgery and its forensic examination. So we are live in a digital era. That is a world where seeing is no longer believing. We all addicted to technology. Now, fact is, technology and digitalization dominates us. That's why the things give advantages and also give disadvantages. Digital forgery. Digital forgery is the process of manipulating documents or image for the intent of financial, social, or political gain. Creating a fake copy or imitation of a document or an object with the intention to deceive. It can involve everything from forging a signature, faking a masterpiece, creating cheap replica of an expensive original device to faking government documents like a license, a birth certificate, etc. It may involve electronic forgery and identity theft. The majority of digital forgery occurs because digitally altered pictures often appeal to the viewer's eye. What is a digital image forgery then? The process of creating fake image has been tremendously simple with the introduction of powerful computer graphics editing software such as Adobe Photoshop, etc. For example, image of children, the crime child pornography, no ma'am, involved is in sexually explicit conduct can be created from innocent image or even without the involvement of an actual child. Thus, the common saying, seeing is believing, is no longer true in this digital age. Next, ma'am. Detection technique. A forgery detection technique has two main methods. That is the active method and second one is the passive method. Digital watermarking and digital signature under the active method and based on tampering process, based on source camera feature, based on statistical characteristics of image under the passive method. Copy move forgery detection and image splicing detection under the these are the tampering process. Block based method, keeper based method, and hybrid method. These are the three methods of the copy move forgery. Forgery detection technique. There are the two authentication approaches of image authentication are mainly based on watermarking or digital signature. Digital signature are standard element of most cryptographic protocol. Suits are commonly used for software distribution, financial transaction, contract management software, and other cases where it is important to detect a forgery or tampering. Then the digital watermarking. It is a technology which identification is embedded into the data carrier in ways that cannot be easily noticed, which is the data usage will not be affected. This technology often protects copyright of multimedia data and protect databases of text files. And second one is a passive authentication. It is a class of authentication technique that use the received image itself only for accessing its authenticity and integrity without any information. That is a digital signature, and second one is a digital watermarking of original image from the sender. Next, ma'am. There are three types of image forgery. First one is the image retouching. Second one is the image splicing. That is the copy paste method. Third one is the image cloning. That is the copy move method. Image retouching. The adjustment of the picture utilizing any editing software to accomplish some particular outcome. For example, to enhance the picture, the clarity of the picture or the clearance of the picture. This procedure does not fundamentally change a picture, but rather improves a specific element of the picture. Second one is the image splicing, that is a copy-paste method. It is commonly used in simple forgery technique that crop and paste region from the same or separate source. It is a type of photographic manipulation which involves computerized splicing at least two picture into a solitary composite picture that might not have the further post-preparing. Third one is the image cloning, that's the copy-move forgery. Also known as the region duplication, it is also most common image alteration method because it is an easy and effective method in any shape and size. Process of detection. Here we start the process of detection. We have to input the image, then convert the YCBCR image space. YCBCR image is a family of color space used as a part of color in digital photographic system. Then separate the Y component. Y component is the yellow component of the image, that is a luma component. Luma is typically paired with the chrominoscence. Then the age map. The age is an image that indicates where age are in the image. Then the calculate the DFT value. That is a DFT is a discrete Fourier transform. Then the generate AD and DA curve. We have to draw a curve AD and DA. For AD curve, we calculate the average and then we perform the DFT of the given image. We have to draw a curve DA by calculating the DFT and taking average of age map of the image. Then this two calculation was done and the plot the curve. After we calculate the peak value of AD curve and DA curve, the high we have to separate the high peak value. If peak occurs high, then display shows yes, that is the image alteration takes place. But the peak is normal, that is no peak occurs, then display shows no, that is image not alteration takes place. Move to the next. There are some challenges. Technological advancement, particularly in the area of digital image, has posed substantial challenges for the law. Digitally altered image are ethically allowed as long as they lack malicious intent, but certain types of forgery may be considered felony in all 50 states and under federal law. For example, identity theft, where a person forged the signature of another, is a felony and punishable by a fine and some years of imprisonment. Move to the next. There is one famous case study. The famous politician Lalu Prasad Yadav posed photoshopped image of Patna rally on 28 August 2017. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, Samajwadi Party President Akhilesh Yadav and Senior Congress Leader Gulam Nabi Azad shared the stage with Lalu Prasad Yadav at RJD's mega rally in Gandhi Maidan in Patna. There was a huge turn for the rally and was all going well for them till purported picture of the rally was tweeted from Lalu Prasad Yadav's personal Twitter account. Many people on social media noticed many flaws in the picture and starting the pointing out to the responses Lalu Prasad Yadav's tweet. Then ANI, that is Asian News International, encountered the Lalu Prasad Yadav posted the fake picture. Then several websites used the ANI picture to draw a conclusion that Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav's picture was a Photoshop. Then one person, that is Amaresh Oja, compared two picture of crowded at different point in time and rightly pointed out the tree were missing in picture tweeted by Lalu Prasad Yadav. Irrespective how crowded the ground gets, that green patch can't simply disappear because most of the trees are taller than the average human. The crowd in the original picture is clearly much less than the one portrayed by the Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav's picture. Move to the next. I conclude, digital forgery involves changing elements of a document or image and representing the changes as a true copies of the original. A number of image forgery detection schemes have been developed to compensate for human visual inspection, which is subjectively and unreliable. Digital forensics is a growing research field that supports the struggle against digital forgery and tampering. Move to the next. So here is my references that I referred for the review my topic.